Good afternoon and welcome inside the Burns Arena for Trailblazers women's basketball on a Saturday afternoon. So glad you join us on today's game. I'm Drayson Ball, running things solo today as the Trailblazers are set to host the Saints of St. Martin's University inside Burns Arena. Glad to have you with us. Going to be breaking down this game for you. Got a couple minutes until tip-off. Going to give you a quick pregame show, give you a few expectations, maybe some keys to the game, and get you all set for tip-off in just about 5.5 minutes time or so. Once again, thanks so much for joining us. Glad to have you in. However you may be listening to today's show, thank you so much. Trailblazers set to host St. Martin's University, the Saints, coming into today's game after losing last night to Colorado Mesa afternoon in the Dixie State Classic. They come into today's game with a 2-1 record, and they are playing their first official away game as the Trailblazers host them inside Burns Arena this afternoon. They come in, like I said, 2-1 record on the season overall. I mentioned they played Colorado Mesa last night in the first game, the very first game of the Dixie State Classic here, and they will play in the final game of the Dixie State Classic here this afternoon. Last night's game, 56-31 against Colorado Mesa. Should note, just watched Colorado Mesa play Northwest Nazarene on this very floor. Just ended a few moments ago. Northwest Nazarene team Trailblazers beat last night 79-70. Defeated Colorado Mesa 54-52 just moments ago right here on this very court. So Colorado Mesa going to be leaving the Dixie State Classic 1-1, and the Saints of St. Martin's trying to salvage one victory, but it's going to have to come at the hands of Dixie State's women's basketball team. And for the Trailblazers, they come into today's matchup 4-1 on the season so far in their sixth game, 3-0 right here inside Burns Arena on this floor, and they will have their hands full with the Saints today, a team that comes in. And really, I'm not sure what that Colorado Mesa game yesterday really taught us about the Saints. They lost pretty handily, a 25-point loss last night, 56-31, and just did not play very well, didn't look very good. But a team that right now, you know, you don't really know what to expect. That was their first loss of the season. A team that averages 59 points per game coming into today's game. They do allow about 60 points per game, so it's about a 50-50 split right there, points scored versus points allowed. They shoot 37% from the field and just 25% from three. They're not a great three-point shooting team, but they can put the ball in the net at times. They have a couple of good scorers, and led by Claire Dingus, the sophomore forward from Spokane, Washington, averages over 15 points per game, and they are led by that sophomore forward. The second leading scorer on the team, Bria Thames, number 25, you're going to hear her name a lot. She loves to bang down low, 13.7 points per game, the senior forward from Beaverton, Oregon. She's going to be one of the key players for this Saints team if they're going to want to have any success over Dixie State, and she's going to be a key part of their offense today. Her and Claire Dingus, the only two Saints players that average in double figures for St. Martin's, and the Trailblazers come into this game needing to be able to contain both of those two if they're going to want to have a chance to win. For Dixie State, I mentioned a 4-1 record, 3-0 overall right here inside Burns Arena. 75.2 points per game for this Trailblazers basketball team, 54.6 points allowed defensively. They're doing a very good job defensively. In fact, yesterday against Northwest Nazarene University, trailed by as many as 12 points about 3 minutes into the third quarter. Then they went on a 15-0 run to finish that third quarter. They really put the clamps down defensively on that Northwest Nazarene team, and they ended up winning that one 79-70, and it really just played solid defense. The Nighthawks went cold in the second half, and I think a lot of that had to do with the way Dixie adjusted defensively in the third quarter. We mentioned it on yesterday's broadcast. We'll mention it once again today. The Trailblazers are outscoring their opponents 112-65 in the third quarter of their games so far this season. So they do a very good job of making adjustments going into halftime. Coach J.D. Gustin does a good job of reading what the other team is trying to do offensively and is able to make some changes and counter those offensive bursts from the other team. Dixie State, 42% from the field and 32% from three. They like to shoot a lot of threes. They had 30 attempted threes in last night's game. They made the majority of them, shot a very good percentage. I think they made 12 threes yesterday, led by Maddie Loftus, who came off the bench and did and played tremendous for the Trailblazers, led all scorers. In fact, Maddie Loftus did off the bench with 15 points. Interesting to note, Allie Franks had 11 points at halftime. You thought she might be on pace to have a 20-point afternoon, scored just 1 point in the second half, but the offensive scoring was carried much by Maddie Loftus in the second half. Chesney Stevens had a good second half as well. Ashley Greenwood chipped in and had a bunch of points there in the second half. And I think, you know, a big team effort last night. You didn't see one particular scorer that had a huge night, 20 or 25 points, but you had a lot of contribution all the way around. I thought London Pavlika played a tremendous game, only 6 points, but she did grab 10 rebounds and had a handful of assists as well. She's going to be key for the Trailblazers coming off their bench today as well. St. Martin's and Dixie State set to do battle. It's going to be a fun one here inside Burns Arena, and we're glad to have you with us on today's broadcast. We're going to take a timeout. We're going to come back. We're going to get you some starting lineups. We're going to get you set for tip-off. We're going to step away right now for the national anthem. Let's take a two-minute timeout, and we'll be back with starters and opening tip-off right after this two-minute timeout on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
You know, we may have started out small, but we were great. Families and fans rallied behind their team. The community cared. And everyone showed up to cheer. Now, we're bigger than ever. Dixie State is going to Division One. But at the end of the day, it's the community and fans that make us great. Whether you give $5 or $1,000, every dollar, every seat in the stands, every one of you can help blaze our trail to Division I athletics, because this is our team.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows, maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome, we need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
I take the road less traveled, run free, unwind, unravel. Someplace outside with lots to do. Green trees, red rocks, and don't forget that blue sky. The sunshine shining, fun shine. Pouring on me, think I might just stay a while. Say hooray all day because the sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me.
Welcome back inside. Burns Arena National Anthem is in the books, and let's go ahead and get you set for tip-off. With our starting lineups today, we'll start with the Saints of St. Martin's. Their starting five, running out a little bit of a different starting five than we saw earlier in the Dixie State Classic in their game against Colorado Mesa. They're going to run out Janelle Sutterlicht, a freshman guard from Toppenish, Washington, alongside number 14, Claire Dingus. We talked about her, the sophomore forward. Number 20, Lauren Morris, will start on the guard line for the Saints alongside number 25, Bria Thames. And 44, Megan Nilsson is your senior center from Colbert, Washington, a two-year transfer from Fresno State. That rounds out the starting lineups for St. Martin's. And now on to Dixie State's starting lineups, the same starters we've seen throughout the first five games of this season. A junior guard from Willard, Utah, and Box Elder High School, number 11, Kesley Stevens. A freshman guard, number 20, Brianna Gillen, from West Jordan, Utah, and Copper Hills High School. The senior forward, the leader of this Dixie State team, and the leading scorer at 16 points per game, number 23, Allie Franks, from Redding, California, and Enterprise High School. A redshirt sophomore from right here in St. George, number 24, Ashley Greenwood, and alongside number 42, Chesney Stevenson, a senior forward from Panguitch, Utah. and Panguitch High School. Those are your starting lineups for the Dixie State women's basketball team. I mentioned Allie Franks had the big first half in yesterday's game, 11 points, was limited to just 1 point in the second half. Northwest Nazarene did a good job containing Franks as she hit three of her first four three-point attempts in that first half, got off to a great start and cooled off a little bit in the second half. But like I mentioned, the scoring was picked up by a handful of different trailblazers. Ashley Greenwood chipped in a bunch of points there in the second half. Chesney Stevens had 8 points in the third quarter. Kesley Stevenson hit a couple of big threes, and I mentioned Maddie Loftus. Just 3 of 10 yesterday from the field, but made all 6 of her free throws, and that's really where she got the bulk of her scoring, as she led all scorers yesterday with 15 points in that contest. She's now up over double figures on her season average, 4 points per game. She was averaging 9 coming into yesterday's game, but the 15-point performance pushed her into double digits, now averaging 10.2 points per game, the senior guard out of South Jordan, Utah, and Bingham High School. And I really love what Coach J.D. Gustin does to get her shots on the floor. I mean, she's a part of the offense where they run plays specifically for Maddie Loftus because she is such a sharp shooting guard on the perimeter, and they like to run some screens and some flare screens and some different things to be able to get her open, get her into space, and get her some open looks. And we'll see if they're able to do that tonight, and she's going to be critical for this Trailblazers team all season long if she can come off the bench and average anywhere close to double figures or more. Trailblazers in their red uniforms with the white trim. St. Martin's in their gray uniforms with the white numbers and the red trim, going right to left on your TV screen. And the Trailblazers will go left to right in those red uniforms. As I see it, you hear it quickly. Trailblazers contain the tip. Ashley Greenwood sets up the offense for Dixie State. Gets to the angle left. Now to Franks, back to Greenwood. Top of the key to Gillen. Allie Franks, dribble handoff. She'll try a three, and she knocks it down. Allie Franks buries the first shot of the game, and it's a three-pointer. And she starts off the scoring for Dixie State. A quick 3-0 lead for the Trailblazers. Claire Dingus on the other end. Hands to Thames on the right wing. Now to Morris on the left wing. Three-pointer is up, no good. Good box out by Allie Franks, and rebound to Chesney Stevens. Into the hands of Ashley Greenwood now, quickly into the front court. She sets up the offense for Dixie State. She was key in yesterday's game. Had 3 early fouls, but was able to get into the game in the second half and play a critical role for Dixie State offensively. On a low block, Chesney Stevens fakes left, now spins back to her right, and her layup is no good, but she will be fouled in the process. Going to give the foul to Megan Nilsson, her first personal foul, first team foul of the afternoon for the Saints. Good move there by Chesney Stevens working on Megan Nilsson. First free throw up and good for Chesney Stevens. Megan Nilsson, low down low, a 6'2 center, as I mentioned, from Colbert, Washington, as the second free throw is missed by Chesney Stevens. And the Saints look to push the tempo. To Morris, she drives baseline. Kicks back into the middle to Sutterlick, and she lays it up and in. Janelle Sutterlick for 2. Gets the scoring started for the Saints. It's a 4-2 lead for Dixie State. Minute and a half gone by in this first quarter. Ashley Greenwood, she'll try a 3 short off the front of the iron. Rebound to Sutterlick. She'll bring the ball and pass it across the timeline up to Claire Dingus, who gets cut off on the baseline left. Now back to Sutterlick, angle left. She'll try a deep three-pointer. It's going to be off the back iron. Long rebound comes out of Greenwood, and she pulls it down and passes ahead to Kesley Stevenson on the angle left. Cross-court pass to Gillen. Gillen now tries to drive. He's cut off in the painted area. Back to Greenwood. Top of the key, she backs up near midcourt, setting up the offense for the Trailblazers. Over to Stevens, angle left, back to Greenwood. She'll try another three, this one no good, too strong off the back iron. Tracked down by Allie Franks, the offensive rebound. Fakes right, goes left, and is now cut off, but a bump and a foul. Gonna be called against the Saints. We'll see who they give it to. It's gonna be on Claire Dingus as she was trying to contain Allie Franks, and an early foul for the leading scorer for this St. Martin's team. Bound pass goes to Kesley Stevenson around the perimeter to Allie Franks behind the back dribble, and she's working on Claire Dingus. Dribble handoff with Gillen. She gets to her right, now over to the angle right. To Greenwood, back to Gillen, top of the key. Shot clock down at 4. Chesney Stevens going to have to fire up a 3, and it's good. Chesney Stevens showing her range as she had to hoist that one up with the shot clock running low. And Chesney Stevenson now with 4 points after a free throw, and that made three-pointer for the Saints on the other end. Janelle Sutterlick now veers to the right, into the corner to Dingus. Cut off in the short corner by Gillen. Back out to the top of the key, faked a 3, and now drives into the low block with Bria Thames. And she can't get the layup to go, but she will be fouled and head to the line for 2 free throws. Chesney Stevens got in her way and called for the block. Her first personal foul, first team foul for Dixie State. And Bria Thames, a 58% free throw shooter on the season, will head to the line for a pair of free throws. Trailblazers leading this one 7-2 early. 3 minutes gone by in this first period. Bria Thames rolls that one around and down. See there, Chesney Stevens got there just a little bit late, had that left foot inside the restricted area. And it's called for the block as Bria Thames connects on both free throws. Lead down to 3, 7-4. Dixie State leads at 3 minutes gone by. Backdoor pass to Allie Franks from London Pavlik. It can't get the layup to go. Had a good look at it. Thought she might have been bumped, but could not get the layup to go. Allie Franks on the pass from Linda Pavliga. Now on the other end, it's Thames. She gets all the way to the rim. She can't get that one to go. Rebound, no to Dingus. She's surrounded by 4 Trailblazers in the key. Tries to lay it up, and she rolls around and in. Claire Dingus, don't know how she got around 4 Trailblazers to get that one up and in, but she does. Upcourt pass now to Kesley Stevens on the other end. Linda Pavliga controls to Franks. Top of the key back to Pavliga. Dribble handoff. She tries to pin it. It gets into the key. Layup is up. No good off the back iron. A good look. It's going to be last touch by Pavlika. Got right around her defender, but could not get that one to go. She was working on Claire Dingus. And a good dribble penetration from Pavlika, but not able to get the layup to go. The other way, St. Martin's. Janelle Sutterlick goes 15-foot jumper and hits. Janelle Sutterlick comes off the screen. It's a little 15-foot jumper and buries it. And the Saints take their first lead of the afternoon, 8-7. London Pavlika brings the ball into the front court. Dribble handoff with Gillen. Now back to the top of the key to Kesley Stevens. Into the corner is Pavlika. She's guarded closely by Lauren Morris. She tries to get it into Stevens. Can't get it to go. Thought she might have been bumped and fell. But Dingus now controls for the Saints. They give it down low to Megan Nelson. She's going to be called for the offensive foul. She was coming down, running the court well, but that's going to be huge for her. A big 6'2 center in the middle of the court now picks up her second foul after she draws the charge. Allie Franks does a good job of stepping in her way and getting her feet set and picking up the second foul on Megan Nelson. 13th foul for the Saints. Chesney Stevens, dribble handoff. Back to Stevens, a flare screen. Allie Franks in the corner. She'll try another 3. No good. Too strong off the back iron. Gillen tried to tap it out. But to no avail. Quickly into the front court is Dingus. 8-foot fading, floating jumper. Rolls around the rim. And now Allie Franks gets it. And up ahead to Gillen. She's got 1-on-1. Spins around her defender. Left-hand layup is no good. Tried to get around Megan Nelson, but the 6-2 frame disrupted the shot enough. And Gillen was not able to get that one to go. Now the Saints into the front court. Thames has it, right to left dribble, now fakes back to her right. Spinning layup is good by Bria Thames. And she's got her 4th point of the afternoon. I mentioned that's what she likes to do. She loves to get to the low block. That's her game. She doesn't shoot a lot of outside shots or mid-range shots. She loves to get to the low block in that restricted area. And that's where she does a lot of her work. Allie Franks now gives to Stevens on the free throw line left. Kesley Stevens kicks to the corner. Now Pavlico, she'll try a long jumper, no good. Rebound to Morris. She brings it into the front court now, and she tries to cake on Kesley Stevens. Gets to the short corner, is cut off. Back out to Nelson and around to Thames. She tries to dribble baseline to the left. Can't get that layup to go. Last touch by Dixie State. And again, this is exactly what they want to do with Bria Thames, is getting her down into the low block. She's a very good driver, but can't get that layup to go, as we are now under 5 minute media timeout. We'll take it. 60 seconds and back on the Trailblazer basketball net.
There is a place where looking out means looking in, where an impression lasting only a few seconds will be imprinted on a life forever, where courage is forged, and innocence rediscovered, where remembering is rewarding and forgetting unforgettable. There is a place where truth is felt and where seeing is believing. There is a place.
Radio Dixie 91.3. We don't play that. Nope, not that. A big fat no there. That's what we play. And stuff like that. On St. George's only alternative, Radio Dixie 91.3. Oh, and from 9 till midnight, we play this.
I need a one dance.
And this. Radio Dixie 91.3 FM.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena, Trailblazers on the losing end of this one, 10-7 early on, 4:19 remaining in the first quarter. Dixie State opened up a 7-2 lead, but a quick 8-0 run for St. Martin's sees them leading this one 10-7 early on in this game. And the Saints will inbound, set up the picket fence, try to find Dingus underneath, can't find her. Outlet pass to Morris. She gets an 18-foot jumper. She'll try it. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Lauren Morris, her first field goal of the afternoon. And the Saints take a 12-7 lead in this game. London Pavlika now controls for Dixie State to Allie Franks on the angle right. Back to Pavlika, top of the key. Thought about a three. Now tries to drive right and left dribble. Gets all the way to the basket. Faked it to underneath. Faked it to Emily Isaacson and London Pavlika. Nice move. Lays that one up and in. On the other end, Morris tries a floating fadeaway jumper. No good. Rebound to Pavlika. Quickly ahead to Maddie Loftus. Right to left dribble. Now back to Pavlika, top of the key. Cross court pass to Stevens and back to Pavlika, setting up the offense for the Trailblazers. She holds, guarded by Sutterlick, and tries to get a bounce pass into Isaacson. Thought it might have been kicked. Ball still loose. Tried to save it as Morris on the sideline. It's going to be a jump ball favoring the Trailblazers. The possession arrow will keep it with Dixie State. And that one, London Pavlika tried to get in, throws it off the foot of Lauren Morris. Was not a kick because she didn't make an attempt to stop it with her foot. It was just thrown off her foot. And the ball is loose, and Loftus ties up Lauren Morris. And the possession arrow favors Dixie State. Kesley Stevenson triggers the inbounds pass. She's got Allie Franks in front of her. And Franks and Pavlika run into each other. And Pavlika has to go into the backcourt to get it. She's got it for the Trailblazers. Comes off the screen from Franks. Now back to her. Angle left to Pavlika. She holds, gives to Loftus, who fakes right, goes left, tries to get to the free throw line extended, can't do it. Kesley Stevenson tried to cut, falls. Now gets to Allie Franks, sticks a shoot on the shot clock. Allie Franks tries to go up and shoot, and she is fouled as she got into the painted area and tried to elevate, but she was fouled. We'll see who they give it to. Referees discussing right now and as to who they're going to give this free throw to. They're going to give it to Lauren Morris for the first. Fourth team foul. Dixie State now in the penalty. And they're saying not a shooting foul on that one. Not sure how that's not a shooting foul. Allie Franks was going into her motion. How is that not a shooting foul? That's bizarre to me, as Franks looked like with 5 seconds on the shot clock had to get that one up. And not awarded free throws on that one. Now get it into Isaacson on the low block. A nice move, a left to right fake. And Emily Isaacson lays that one up and in. She's on the board for Dixie State. Now cut into the lead 12-11. Sutterlick on the other end. She'll try a deep three and she hits it. Janelle Sutterlick open up the scoring in a big way for the Saints. She's got 7 points on the afternoon. A player averaging just 2 points on the season. She's already got 7 for the Saints early on in this one. Pavlika gives to Franks, had an open three, didn't take it. Now into the corner, Maddie Loftus, she'll take it. No, it's too strong, doesn't draw iron, and the Saints will take over. Tierney Diodontis now into the game, gives to Sutterlick, and she goes all the way to the basket, can't get it to go. Rebound to Allie Franks. Pavlika now into the front court, gives to Maddie Loftus, thought about a three, now drives and kicks to London Pavlika. Pavlika being guarded by Sutterlick, gives to Franks, top of the key, right to left dribble. Dribble handoff with Pavlika. She now brings it back to the top of the key, gives to Kesley Stevenson. She'll take a three. It's up, no good. Too strong off the back of the iron. Kesley Stevenson misses that one, and Sutterlick now controls for the Saints. Entry pass into Dingus. Now she kicks out to Thames, who thought about a three, won't take it. Back to Dedonatis. She'll penetrate, kicks. Three-pointer is up and good. Mallory Vivola drills a three for the Saints. A 50% three-point shooter on the season. And the Saints now take a 6-0 run and lead this one 18-11. A minute and a half remaining in the first quarter. Pavliga spins to her left, gets into the paint, kicks to Kessie Stevenson around to Allie Frank. She's got an open three-pointer. She'll take it and she'll hit it. Nice penetration and kick from London Pavlica. She won't get the assist, but she'll get the hockey assist as she finds Kessie Stevenson in the corner, who whips it around the perimeter to Allie Franks. A turnover on the other end by Tierney Dedonatis. But a good ball movement possession on that three-pointer. London Pavlica creating it all with the penetration, the kick to Kessie Stevenson, and around the perimeter to Allie Franks, who buries her second three of the afternoon. Now Isaacson gives to Loftus and over to Pavlica. Pavlica, cross-court pass to Loftus, right to left dribble. She gets all the way to the lane, and she lays it up and in. A nice move from Maddie Loftus, who play was designed for her to get a three, but it was taken. She decided to put it on the floor and got all the way to the rim. And she lays that one up and in for her first 2 points of the afternoon. Rebound to Pavlica on the other end. She gets into the front court now. Gives to Kessie Stevenson. She'll try a three. No good, it's off the back iron. And rebound out to the Saints. Dedonatis gives to Sutterlicht. Shot clock and game clock virtually in sync, maybe a half a second difference between shot clock and game clock, but for all intents and purposes, the Saints can play for the final shot here. Sutterlicht controls, yo-yo dribble now left to right. Comes off a screen, she'll try a three-pointer, looks good, no good off the back iron. Probably doesn't have time. Rebound to Kessie Stevenson with three, with two. Stevenson tries a long three, and it's going to come up short. But a good look there to end the first quarter for Dixie State as they cut into the lead, a 5-0 run for themselves to end this quarter, and they trail at 18-16. And we will take a one-minute timeout. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
I got you right where I want you. I make this one, it's over. I win.
No pressure. Bring it.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
When I was growing up, my mom was extremely tidy. We were trained to put things back where we got them from. One day, when I walked into my mom's house, I felt like I walked to someone else's house. There was stuff everywhere. And just growing up, the way I grew up, and to see this transition was very alarming.
When Sean talked to me, it was a wake-up call, and that's when I went to the doctor.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. First quarter action over, and we are moments away from beginning second quarter. 18-16 lead for St. Martin's. A back and forth first period, and saw the Trailblazers lead 7-2, and then St. Martin's went on a run and held the lead for the rest of the quarter. Into Ding as she tries to lay it up. No good. Allie Franks the rebound. And now to Pavlica. She controls for Dixie State and brings the ball across midcourt. Comes off a screen set by Franks. St. Martin switch back to Franks. She thought about a three. She gets all the way to the low block. Can't lay it up and in, though, as that one she got all the way into the rack and could not get that one to go. Dedonatis on the other end. She kicks to Vivola, now down low to Dingus, who tries to lay it up and in. Can't get it to go, though, and she will go to the line for two free throws. Claire Dingus go to the line, 60% free throw shooter on the season, and she'll get a pair of free throws for the Saints. First one up and good. Dingus now up to 3 points after one field goal and the free throw. She will get one more and rolls around, falls out. Rebound to Loftus. Ashley Greenwood back into the game for Dixie State. She controls for the Trailblazers. Setting up the offense, now tries to penetrate. London Pavlica on the angle right, tries to find Stevens down low. An errant pass sells out of bounds. off the hand of London Pavlik. They're trying to find Stevens on the low block, and she can't find her. A turnover for Dixie State. They had 22 turnovers in last night's game. Hopefully they can cut down on that number today. As London Pavlik commits the turnover on the other end. Sutterlick gives to DeDonatis. Now to the top of the key to Fane. Into the corner, Vivola trying to find Dingus on the low block. Can't find her. Around the perimeter to Sutterlick. She cuts to the top of the key. A 7 to shoot on the shot clock. Gets the shot off. Rolls off back iron and in. Janelle Sutterlick coming out of nowhere. Now up to 9 points. She leads all scorers in the afternoon for both teams. Ashley Greenwood now. Allie Franks top of the key. She'll try a deep three-pointer off the front iron. Doesn't get the shooter's bounce and rebound. Controlled by Fane. Quickly into the front court is DeDonatis. Right to left dribble. She gets into the paint. Nice pump fake move. And she can't get it to go with the rebound to Thames. Instead a whistle, however. And she's going to be called for the offensive foul. Going over the back. Bria Thames with her first personal foul. First team foul in the quarter. Dixie State regains possession. Is a nice move there by DeDonatis. But Thames came in and pushed Ashley Greenwood in the back. And draws a first foul of the afternoon for Thames. Greenwood now gives to Franks. Angle right tries to go back door to Stevenson, who punches it out to London Pavlika. Around the perimeter, now to Franks, to Maddie Loftus, who's got a wide open three in the corner, and she buries it. Excellent ball movement for Dixie State on that possession. And Chesney Stevens punched it out, literally punched it to London Pavlika, who went all the way around the perimeter, three passes to find Maddie Loftus in the opposite corner. And she had an open three and buried it. On the other end now, Vivola gives to Thames. Free throw line, left to right dribble. She gets to the low block. Good defense there by Stevens. Claire Dingus comes down with it. And she's going to be knocked to the ground in a whistle. Looks like they're going to get London Pavlika on the foul. Indeed they do. London Pavlika picks up her first personal foul. Second team foul in the quarter for Dixie State. Saints set up the picket fence, outlet pass now to Thames, and left with McKenna Schultz into the ball game now for the Saints. She comes off a screen set by Dingus. Now back to her, top of the key. Junction right, Thames left to right, now back to her left. Spins back to her right, gets to the low block, lays it up and in. Bria Thames, all sorts of moves out of the hat on that possession as she went one way, back to the other, and spun back to her right and got that one to go. Loftus, entry pass into Greenwood. She tries to lay it up, but a foul is going to be called on the Saints. And a good post-up move from Ashley Greenwood. She handles the ball. She's the point guard for this Dixie State offense. But she has got the body to be able to go down there low and kind of bang and post up. And she gets Mallory Vivola to draw to Fowler. She draws the contact. She'll go to the free throw line for two shots. Greenwood, a 91% free throw shooter on the season, the five games so far, and she knocks down the first, her first point of the afternoon. The redshirt sophomore from St. George, right here in St. George, Utah, and Desert Hills High School, and she gets both free throws to go. And the Trailblazers cutting into the lead ever more, 23-21 lead. St. Martin's, 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. Vivola drives baseline, is cut off. Kicks out to DeDonatis. She tries to get it to Dingus. Top of the key. Now over the angle right. And Schultz, she dribbles Pendrick, gets into the key. Cut off by two defenders. Now kick out past Vivola for three. Rattles around the rim and out. Rebound to Pavlika. She's trying to push the tempo. Now she'll back it up and cross the midcourt line. And tries to find Greenwood in the corner. Back to Pavlika, top of the key. She resets the offense for Dixie State. 19 to shoot on the shot clock. Trailblazers trying to tie or take the lead on this possession. Entry pass into Stevens and a whistle. Going to be a foul on the Saints as they try to get Stevens, Bria Thames, her second personal foul. Third team foul in the quarter. Thames 6 points, and she will come out with her second personal foul just 3.5 minutes into the second quarter. Ashley Greenwood triggers the inbounds. Tries to find Stevens, can't do it now. He gives it Allie Franks, a high pass. Franks can't control it, and stolen away by Claire Dingus. And she gives to McKenna Schultz, who crosses the midcourt line. Sets up the offense for St. Martin's. She yo-yos with the left hand. Over to Vivola, angle left. trying to find a cutter down low. Now has to kick it back to Detonatis. Detonatis left to right dribble. Now gives to Dingus. She tries to drive, penetrate into the low block. Lays it up, catches the rim and in. Claire Dingus, her fifth point of the afternoon. 15.3 points per game for Claire Dingus, the leading scorer for the Saints, as she was able to drive and get to the low block and lay that one up and in for her fifth point. Allie Franks now. Dribble handoff with Greenwood, who fakes left, goes right, kicks to the corner. Maddie Loftus now. She drives, penetrates, layup up, no good off the front of the iron. A good look for Maddie Loftus, but just could not get that one to go. And then a foul is committed on the offensive rebound try by Chesney Stevens, her second personal foul, second team foul of the afternoon as well. And the Saints will retain possession, 25-21 lead. 5:38 to go in the second quarter. Similar game as so far that we saw yesterday, as Claire Dingus can't get the 15-foot jumper to go. The Trailblazers led early, gave up the lead, and then fought their way back as Maddie Loftus, she tries a three in transition off the front iron, can't get it to go, but the offensive rebound by Brianna Moyati. She tries to go up and under and lay it up. No good, but she's going to be fouled, going to give McKenna Schultz her first foul. As Brianna Moai got the offensive rebound, working hard on the low block. You see she grabs it there, tries to take one dribble and up and under. Can't get the layup to go, but is fouled on the attempt by McKenna Schultz. Fourth team foul now for St. Martin's, and they'll be in the bonus the rest of the way. Will Dixie State. Moai hard off the back iron and falls. Friendly bounce for Brianna Moyati. First free throw make of the season. She was 0 of 2 up to that point in the season and makes both free throws. 2 points for Moyati. Now into the front court. Detonatis. Ears right. Comes off a screen. Now gets to the baseline. Tries to kick to the opposite corner. Claire Dingus, a three pointer. Rattles off the rim and out. Ashley Greenwood now into the front court for Dixie State. Left-hand dribble now finds Kesley Stevenson. Back to Greenwood, top of the key. Entry pass into Brianna Moyati. Moyati now turns into her defender, and it's going to be whistled as a tie-up. Possession arrow favors Dixie State. Once again, we're going to have our under-media timeout. The Trailblazers trying to cut into this lead and get over the hump. Right now trailing 25-23 with 4:47 remaining in the second quarter. We're going to take a 60-second timeout. We'll be back with more first-half action here inside Burns Arena right after this 60-second timeout.
For over a century, Dixie State University has been shaping the Trailblazers of tomorrow by providing a culture of active learning, active life. With a paradigm of real-world experience mixed with cutting-edge technologies and rich traditions, we provide one of the most affordable educations in the West, set against the most stunning backdrop on the planet.
Hi, I'm Smokey Colbert, filling in because for 75 years, Smokey only said,
"Only you can prevent wildfires."
Meanwhile, the song was wrong. We did start the fire. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
Play Eric Amarola's Race Day Mix.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. St. Martin's leading this one 25-23. 4:47 remaining in the second quarter. Dixie State trying to fight their way back into this one. We're outscored 18-16 in the first period, but have now evened up the Saints 7-7 so far in the second quarter. As they trigger the inbound to Moyati. To Ashley Green, she tries to penetrate, gets to the low block inside the restricted area, and she lays it up and in for two. A nice move there by Ashley Greenwood, who would not be denied on her way to the rack, and she lays that one up and in with her offhand. And the Trailblazers now even things up 25 apiece. The Saints on the other end. Jayla Russ into the ballgame for the first time. She tries to drive baseline, cut off by Moyati to Dingus. Now at the top of the key to Vivola. Long three-pointer by Jayla Russ. No good. A little bit out of her range, perhaps. And rebound to Ashley Greenwood. Quickly into the front court to Maddie Loftus, who thought about a transition three and said gives to Isaacson on the low block. Now to Brianna Moyati. And she'll be tied up once again. This time, possession arrow favors the Saints. Trailblazers want to try to get up the court. They shoot a lot of threes, as we know. And if they're hitting them, they're tough to beat. Dixie State now on a mini 4-0 run to even things up, 25 apiece with 4 minutes remaining till halftime. The Saints now on the other end. Vivola tries a deep three, and she'll hit it. Mallory Vivola, her second three-pointer of the afternoon. And she now gives the Saints a three-point lead, 28-25. Ashley Greenwood for Dixie State on the other end, right to left dribble. She gives to Isaacson. She'll try a three-pointer, can't answer. Long rebound taken by Schultz. Quickly into the front court now to Dinga. She controls angle left. Now picks up a dribble around the perimeter to Vivola. Entry pass into Schultz. Now kick out to Jayla Russ, who thought about a three, won't take it. Sutterlick in the corner. She'll take a three. She's been on fire so far today, but can't get that one to go. As Ashley Greenwood now brings the ball into the front court for Dixie State. Cross court pass to Kessie Stevens. She'll try a three, no good, off the front iron. And track down into the corner. The rebound is Schultz. She quickly gets it ahead to Dinga. She drives baseline. Brianna Moyati comes over to try to contest a shot. Good job on the contest. And Emily Isaacson brings in the rebound, trying to throw it all the way down court to Kessie Stevenson, who tried to lay it up and in but can't get it to go. That would have been a home run pass from Greenwood to Stevenson, but not able to get that one to go on the layup. We have Allie Franks and Deshka Olson now checking in for Dixie State. Brianna Moyati and Kesley Stevenson coming out for the Trailblazers. Would have been fun to see that one go. Kind of a long, almost a 75-foot pass from Greenwood to Kesley Stevenson, who just could not get the layup to go on the previous possession. Greenwood now into the front court. Isaacson top of the key, now to Franks. Greenwood back to Franks, try to throw a three, now Goodson into the paint and can't get the easy layup to go. I thought she might have overthought that one, tried to float and lean into that when she had an open lane, but decided to not take it. Schultz now tries to penetrate, and she's fouled on the perimeter. No shot on the play. And they're going to whistle Deshka Olson, fresh into the game for Dixie State, for her first personal foul, fourth team foul in the quarter for the Trailblazers. Saints now in the bonus the rest of the way. McKenna Schultz will trigger the inbounds pass for the Saints. She gives to Sutterlicht. Sutterlicht now calling out the plays for the Saints as she veers now towards the angle right, guarded closely by Ashley Greenwood. Ball nearly stolen away, now gives to Dingus in the corner. Back to Vivola, top of the key. She tries to dribble, cut off by Olsen. Now gets to the low block, and she lays that one up and in. Nice little hesitation move by Mallory Vivola. She's got eight points on the afternoon. Up to 8 points. And on the other end, Greenwood gives to Allie Franks on the right junction. Tries to find Greenwood. She's got a wide open three. She'll take it and she'll bury it. Ashley Greenwood off the feed from Allie Franks knocks down a three-pointer. She's got 7 points now. And Dixie State within two, 30-28. Trailblazers working hard. Try to keep this game close. Sutterlicht on the other end. Gives to Vivola, drives baseline, cut off by Olsen. Now kick out back to Sutherland. Into the corner for Schultz. She'll try a three-pointer. No good, off back iron. Rebound to Sutherland, though. Left to right dribble, gets to the 15-foot jump area, and she throws it up. No good, rebound to Allie Franks. Ashley Greenwood now into the front court for the Trailblazers. Fresh off a made three. Gives to Loftus, behind the back dribble. Now gives to Franks and to Olsen in the right corner. Back to Frank, 16 to shoot for the Trailblazers, under a minute to go in the quarter. Deshka Olson now into the corner, tries to penetrate, gets into the paint, kicks out to Ashley Greenwood, 8 to shoot for Dixie State. She goes left to right, tries to get around her defender, a whistle and a foul, no shot. And it's going to be 2 shots for Allie Franks as the Trailblazers are in the bonus. Dixie State, 30-28, could even things up here as you see. Ashley Greenwood does a nice job of trying to get around Emily Nelson. And Nelson could not hang with her and had to foul her on her way by. And Ashley Greenwood will get another pair of free throws from the stripe. Hard off the back iron, no good on the first. Ashley Greenwood 8 points per game. She's got seven already today. A 91% free throw shooter coming into today's game. 2 of 3 so far on the afternoon. Second one is up and good, and Greenwood matches her season average already in the first half. As we have 45 seconds and counting remaining in the first half of action. Trailblazers Saints inside Burns Arena in the Dixie State Classic. Dingus now cross-court pass to Sutterlich. She fakes left, drives baseline, cross-court pass, now finds Schultz down to Dingus on the low block. She kicks out. Three-pointer is up by Nelson, no good. And it's going to be off. Last touched by the Saints. And Dixie State will get one more possession. Not sure if that one was the right call. No review. We do not have replay in today's game, but that one might have been last touched by Emily Isaacson. Shot clock now turned off. 20 seconds remaining as Ashley Greenwood brings the ball into the front court. The Trailblazers can take the final shot of the second quarter. Working down, now under 10 we go. Ashley Greenwood comes off the screen from Isaacson. Now back to Isaacson. She gives to Maddie Loftus. And Ashley, Allie Frank, top of the key. She's got to get a shot up two, and with one 15-foot fading jumper is no good. Not a great final possession of the quarter for Dixie State. They had to rush a shot. Their first action didn't work, and Allie Franks had to force one up at the buzzer. And Dixie State goes into halftime, trailing once again 30-29, but we know what they can do after halftime, outscoring opponents 112-65 in second half, in third quarters, excuse me. And we'll see what they are able to do in the third quarter and the second half. We will see what they're able to do in the second half. Trailblazers trail this one 30-29, 14-45 until we begin the second half action. Let's take a 5-minute halftime timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you some first half stats. We'll see if we have some first half highlights for you. And we'll talk about what Dixie State needs to do to get back into this one in the second half. We take 5-minute timeout and back on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
You know, we may have started out small, but we were great. Families and fans rallied behind their team. The community cared, and everyone showed up to cheer. Now, we're bigger than ever. Dixie State is going to Division One. But at the end of the day, it's the community and fans that make us great. Whether you give $5 or $1,000, every dollar, every seat in the stands, every one of you can help blaze our trail to Division I athletics. Because this is our team.
Hey, Bobo, do trees tell each other stories?
I'm sorry, I'm afraid I don't know that.
Hey, why don't we go find out? Listen.
Can birds draw pictures?
I don't have an answer for that.
Dad, do stars visit their friends?
Look!
For over a century, Dixie State University has been shaping the Trailblazers of tomorrow by providing a culture of active learning, active life. With a paradigm of real-world experience mixed with cutting-edge technologies and rich traditions, we provide one of the most affordable educations in the West set against the most stunning backdrop on the planet.
Where do you find the titans of classical music in St. George? classical music on Radio St. George, 100.3 FM. Where do you find the legends of jazz? Evenings on Radio St. George, 100.3 FM.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
1 in 3 adults has prediabetes. That means it could be you, your favorite brother, your other brother, you, your football buddy, your football buddy, you, your plumber.
Breathe right into your foot.
Your plumber's masseuse.
Yes.
You, your dog walker, your cat jogger. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org.
There is a place where rocks bleed and nature blushes on a battlefield green with envy. Where dimples determine destiny and a tiny wooden teeth holds the outcome in the balance. There is a place where friends are opponents and opponents are friends. Where the prize is elusive, the conquest is captivating, and the score isn't settled till the drinks are down. There is a place.
All right, man, I need you to go deep.
All right, I'll catch this one, I promise. Post route, back of the end zone.
Got it, let's do it.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. Dixie State doing battle with St. Martin's University, a 30-29 lead for the Saints as we welcome you to the halftime show. And once again, I want to thank you for joining us for Dixie State women's basketball in an interesting first half of action for Dixie State. They got out to an early lead and then surrendered a 9-0 run to St. Martin's and just were not able to get back over the hump. They tied it once or twice and just were not able to get over the hump despite a rough quarter on both ends. 30-29 lead for St. Martin's. And they shoot 36.4% in that first half and 25% from three. And they outshoot Dixie State in the first half from the field, 30% from the field for Dixie State. Just 9 of 30 are the Trailblazers from the field in the first half. They do have 5 threes, 5 of 16, and 31.3% from deep. And, you know, Allie Franks has hit a couple. Chesney Stevens hit the one early in the first quarter. Ashley Greenwood's hit one. Maddie Loftus has hit one. And the Trailblazers, like I mentioned, in the first half of play, they're hitting their three-pointers. They're tough to beat, but right now they're not making much else. Just 4 made field goals, not three-pointers, as they are just 9 of 30 from the field in the first half. The encouraging thing for Dixie State is they are right in it, and they outscore their opponents by a wide margin in third quarters of ball games. 112-65, Dixie State is outscoring opponents in the third quarter. They also are outscoring them 80-61 in the fourth quarter. So the Trailblazers, a combined 192 points compared to the 126 points allowed in the second half of action. So the good news is that the Trailblazers are very good at making halftime adjustments and coming out and playing very well in the second half of action. I think one of the things about this team is maybe the Trailblazers thought they were just going to come in here and roll over St. Martin's, who the Trailblazers saw yesterday be beat by 25 points to Colorado Mesa. And I think they may have underestimated the Saints, but a team that has come in and played well and has played hungry and owned a 30-29 lead at the halftime break. Let's get things started. We'll get some first half stats for you. Let's run those right now. If we have some, let's do some first half instead. If not, we'll get you some stats in a minute. We'll do some first half highlights is what we want to do right now. as we see Allie Franks. She got the scoring starting early with a three-pointer on the first Trailblazers possession. This was the possession that London Balaga goes right to left dribble, gets all the way to the paint, and then this one, the spin move, the kick to Kesley Stevenson, and then Allie Franks buries the three-pointer. That was a fun possession. Good ball movement on that one for Dixie State. And then Maddie Loftus, she gets into the painted area and lays that one up and in. Maddie Loftus had a good first half, 5 points, a three, and that there's the three right there for Maddie Loftus. She had 5 points, and you saw them all right there. Then Ashley Greenwood, the leaning jumper there inside the restricted area, and she gets it to go. Allie Franks now kicks to Greenwood, and she drills a three. Greenwood playing very well as well. She has 8 points for Dixie State, and we'll give you some first half stats. We'll start with St. Martin's. I told you the story coming in to today's game. Claire Dingus was the leading scorer on the team, 15.3 points per game. She was limited to just 5 points in the first half. The big storyline, Janelle Sutterlicht, a freshman guard from Toppenish, Washington, has 9 points in the first half, and that's noteworthy. She came into today's game only averaging 2 points per game. She got the start for Dixie State in this one, and she did do just about everything in that first half. 9 points for her, and she leads all scorers right now on both teams with 9 points. She's also got 4 rebounds and an assist. Mallory Vivola off the bench for the Saints, 8 points, and Bria Thames, she was a big storyline in that first quarter as well. She's got to the basket just about whenever she's wanted. She's converted three of those. Two of five from the field, and then a couple of free throws. She's got 6 points and 6 rebounds. And Claire Dingus, like I mentioned, only limited to 5 points, the leading scorer for the Saints. With help in check, the Trailblazers are going to have to key in on her and make sure she doesn't beat them, but they're also going to try to have to stop Janelle Sutterlicht right now, who she has been on fire all throughout the game. For Dixie State, I mentioned Ashley Greenwood. She leads the Trailblazers in scoring with 8 points. She's also grabbed 4 rebounds on the defensive end. 6 points for Allie Franks, 5 points for Maddie Loftus. She had the three and the layup in the first half. 4 points for Chesney Stevenson. She had a three and a free throw. 2 points each for Lena Pavlika and Brianna Moyati, as well as Emily Isaacson. And the Trailblazers look to come out and play a better second half of action after the halftime break. I mentioned, you know, maybe they just came in and were just not quite expecting what they got from the Saints in the first half. I thought they were the more aggressive team. The Trailblazers only turned the ball over 3 times. That was one of the big storylines of yesterday's game. They had 11 turnovers at halftime yesterday. They finished with 11 second half turnovers, 22 turnovers in total in yesterday's game. It was one of the big storylines for that contest between Northwest Nazarene and the Trailblazers. But only 3 turnovers is key for Dixie State in this game. They average on the season 15.4 turnovers as a team, so well under that margin right now. If they can keep the turnovers to under 10 in this game, and that's pretty lofty expectation. Usually, you know, if you're within 11 to 12 or maybe even 13 turnovers, you feel pretty happy. But with only 3 turnovers at halftime, you got to feel like you can maybe get out of here only having 6, maybe 7 or 8 turnovers. And if you can do that, you give yourself a really good chance in the second half. Trailblazers were outscored in the first period, like I mentioned, 18-16, but then outscored the Saints 13-12 in the second quarter to bring themselves within one, a 30-29 lead. Dixie State going to have a lot to do in the second half if they're going to want to keep the Saints at bay and come away with their 4th straight victory. Trailblazers on a 3-game road win streak. It was a 3-game win streak. Not on the road, all here at home. I should mention a home win streak. Dixie State beating La Sierra, Life Pacific, and Northwest Nazarene last night to have a 3-game win streak. And right here inside Trailblazer, inside Burns Arena, they'll try to keep that alive in the second half of action. We got our dance cam going on right now. We will take a quick 2-minute timeout, and we'll be back with second half action right here on the Trailblazers Basketball Network. Welcome back inside Burns Arena as we get you set for second half action between Dixie State and St. Martin's University. And an eventful and fun Brooks dance cam we had just now on the Jumbotron up in center court here in Burns Arena. And a lot of action on that dance cam. And a good chuckle as we are underway in the second half. Ashley Greenwood controls for Dixie State. She sets up the offense for the Trailblazers. Now veers to her left, gives to Kesley Stevenson. Back to Greenwood, top of the key, tries to find Stevenson at the high post. She's looking for a cutter, tries to find Gillen. She does. She gets into the low block to the basket, fading four-foot jumper, and she got it. Nice play design. Brianna Gillen puts in her first bucket of the afternoon. 2 points for her. And on the other end, quickly, a score from Claire Dingus. She's got the first points for the Saints in the second half. Ashley Greenwood now finds Allie Franks. Top of the key, gives to Chesney Stevens. Thought about a three, now she drives. Pushed off, and a little bit of a flop there from Dingus. Not a lot of contact, and Steven gets her own rebound. Now to Allie Franks and Greenwood around the perimeter. Dribble handoff with Gillen. Limited action, left to right dribble. She gets into the paint, kicks out to Kesley Stevenson. A wide open three-pointer, and she buries it. The penetration from Brianna Gillen and the kick out to Kesley Stevenson, and she drills a three-pointer, and the Trailblazers now lead 34-32. Janelle Sutterlicht, 9 points for her in the first half. She controls the tempo for the Saints. Into Thames, right to left dribble, but she's going to be called for the travel. She picked up her pivot foot before putting the ball on the deck, and that's going to be a travel violation called on Bria Thames. Dixie State regains possession after a 5-2 run to begin the second quarter, to take the second half to take the lead. Allie Franks tries to go back door to Greenwood, can't find her. Now down low to Greenwood on the low block. She goes fakes right, now goes fakes left, now goes back to her right. Can't get the layup to go, however, and rebound is controlled by the Saints. Quickly ahead to Vivola. She'll try a three-pointer, no good, off back iron. Rebound to Gillen. She brings it coast to coast herself. She's got numbers around the back dribble. Now kicks out to Kessie Stevenson. She'll try another three. No good. This one too strong off back iron. Chased down by Stevenson. Over to Kesley, and she'll try another three. Can't get the second one to go. And the rebound was tracked down by Stevens, not Stevenson. I keep making that mistake. Chesney Stevens and Kesley Stevenson. A little tongue twister there. Saints now on the other end. Thames over to Sutterlicht. Down to the low block to Megan Nielsen. She was quiet in the first half. She gets a left-hand hook shot to go. Megan Nielsen did not score in the first half. Was harped with foul trouble. Had two early fouls in that period and sat the majority of the first half. She gets her first bucket of the afternoon to go, and we're tied at 34. Ashley Greenwood now in the low block. Now brings it back out of the high post. Left right to left dribble, and she can't get the layup to go. She's bumped, however, in a foul, and she'll go to the free throw line to two shots. Nice job of drawing the foul on Bria Thames. That's her third. That's interesting for the Saints. It's Bria Thames. You see the right to left dribble, and just got the body into Ashley Greenwood, and she draws her third personal foul. That's going to be interesting. She's one of the leading scorers for this Saints team, and she will have to come out with three fouls. Tierney Dedonatis comes in for the Saints as Ashley Greenwood toes the free throw line. Spins the ball and knocks this one through. Ashley Greenwood now up to 9 points for Dixie State. She's been to the free throw line. This will be her sixth attempt from the free throw line. She's 4 of 5 so far in the game, and she gets this one hard off the back iron. Rebound though to Allie Franks, and she dribbles by 15-foot floating jumper is no good. Rebound though, Allie Franks, and she'll try another floating jumper, and she'll hit this one. Allie Franks got her own rebound, stayed with it, and took a little 8-foot floater, and she got that one to go. Franks now with 8 points, Dixie State at 3.3, 37-34, 7 minutes to play in the third quarter. On the other end, Dedonatis, entry pass into Nielsen. Back to Dedonatis, she'll take a step back three-pointer, and she'll hit it. Tierney Dedonatis, a 20% three-point shooter so far this season, and she hits her first bucket of the afternoon. 37-37, now Allie Franks, dribble handoff with Ashley Greenwood. She gets into the paint, into the restricted area, floats, hits, Ashley Greenwood now in the double figures for Dixie State as she got into the painted area and hit the floating jumper with her left hand. She's got 11 for Dixie State. On the other end, Detonatis dribbles now angle right. Cross court pass into the corner. Three-pointer is up and no good. That was Dingus who tried to get that one up in the corner. Ashley Franks, Allie Franks now stringing the court. She gets the pass from Ashley Greenwood and she's fouled on her layup attempt. Allie Franks was streaking the court, and Allie Franks was streaking the court. Oh, Ashley Greenwood, another tongue twister for you there, found her underneath the basket, but Franks able to drop contact, and she'll go to the free throw line. They're going to get Vivola, Mallory Vivola, for her second personal foul, as Mallory Vivola commits that foul on Allie Franks. Franks' first free throw is short. No good for the senior from Redding, California. Maddie Loftus and Emily Isaacson now into the game for Dixie State. A deep knee bend for Allie Franks. The second free throw is up and good. Franks now with 9 points. And the Trailblazers hold a 40-37 lead. 4 minutes gone by in the second half of action. Detonatis now veers to her left, gives to Dingus, top of the key. Over to Vivola on the right wing. Cross-court pass to Detonatis, fakes left, goes right, now back to her left, and kicks out to Sutterlich. Sutterlich, she'll try a deep three-pointer of the shot clock at 6 seconds remaining on the clock, and she can't get that one to go. Rebound to Franks. Maddie Loftus fakes a three in transition. Allie Franks and Loftus playing back and forth, now gives to Ashley Greenwood. Dribble handoff with Loftus. Picks up her dribble and finds Gillen on the left wing. Down low to Isaacson. Cross-court pass to Greenwood, who fakes right, goes left, gets into the paint. And we're going to have a whistle and a foul, looks like. Going to be called on Tierney Detonatis. We got that right arm into the body, of Ashley Greenwood. Greenwood inbounds now to Allie Franks, who fakes left, goes right, tries a 10-foot floating jumper, can't get it to go. Clangs off back iron. Detonatis, cross-court pass now to Sutterlich. Angle right, Vivola gets into the paint, spins to her left, and we're going to have no shot. We're going to have a foul before the shot. Going to be called on Brianna Gillen, her first team foul for the Trailblazers in the quarter. You see here, Vivola gets into the high post area and spins back to her left, but the foul on the play before the shot. Detonatis as it now veers to her right. Sutter looked on the quarter, in the top of the key, excuse me. Down low to Nelson. Dingus now, cross-court pass to Dingus, excuse me, to Detonatis. Her three-pointer is no good, but the follow by Emily Nelson is good on the offensive rebound. And Emily Nelson gets her first two of the afternoon. Entry pass into Gillen, cross-court pass to Isaacson. And now to Ashley Greenwood. She fakes right, goes up, but she's going to be called for the travel. Ashley Greenwood caught that one on the top of the key. Faked right, went to the left, but that's one of the emphases of this season is the traveling on that specific play. When you fake right and go left, if you move both your feet, you're going to be called for the travel every single time, as you see. She picks up. No, I don't know about that one. I don't love that call. That one looked like she kept that right foot on the floor. But either way, it's going to be a travel. And we'll take a timeout. 60 seconds and we'll be back on the Trailblazers Basketball Network.
When you adopt a shelter pet, you discover all the things that make them unique.
And your mother.
They're a little bit of a lot of things, but they're all pure love.
Give your town a reason to celebrate, because every Goodwill item you bring home brings job training and more to your community. Goodwill, bring good home.
I got you right where I want you. I make this one, it's over, I win.
No pressure, bring it.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good,
we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
Welcome back. Trailblazers leading this one 40-39, 4.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Dixie State outscoring St. Martin's right now 11-9 in the third quarter, and they own a 1-point lead. Sutterlick now, she goes right to the basket on a drive, and she lays that one up and in. Janelle Sutterlick now in double figures for St. Martin's. 11 points for her. Ashley Greenwood, dribble handoff with Loftus. Top of the key to Isaacson. Loftus and around to Gillen. Back to Loftus. She's got an open three-pointer. She'll take it and she'll hit it. That's the play design they love to run for Maddie Loftus, that little flare screen. As she gets it to the top of the key, comes back off a flare screen, and she loves to hit that shot, and she does. She's got 8 points now off the bench for Dixie State, and they own a 43-41 lead. Detonatis fakes the dribble handoff. She gets to the baseline, is cut off by Loftus, and she stepped on the end line. Good defense from Maddie Loftus as she forced Detonatis into the baseline, and that tough area underneath the basket where there's, she can't really shoot, and she has to kind of turn and pass it out, but she stepped on the end line. And good defense there from Maddie Loftus. Yeah, right there, great camera angle from our CEC TV crew. We love our CEC TV camera operators, and they give us one of the best broadcasts in the entire country, if not the best. Gillen, cross-court pass into the corner for Loftus, and she buries another three. Maddie Loftus has caught fire in this third quarter, back-to-back threes for the senior guard from Bingham High School and South Jordan, Utah. On the other end, an answer to the three by Mallory Vivola. Up and down we go. She's got 11 points, and the Trailblazers holding on to a 2-point lead, 46-44. We have a whistle, stoppage of play. Not sure what it was. Looks like it might have called a delay of game warning on the Saints. As Mallory Vivola answers Maddie Loftus's three on the other end with a three of her own. London Pavlinga back into the game for Dixie State. She picks up her dribble, gives to Stevens on the angle left. Down low to Brianna Gillen, back out to Stevens. She'll try a three-pointer, no good, off the back iron. Long rebound out, contained by Jayla Russ. Now into the front court, now Detonatis. Gives to Dinga, she drives baseline, is cut off. Gives out to Sutterlick. She tries to dribble, penetrate, now back into the low block to Dingus. Out to Jayla Russ and around the perimeter to Vivola. She now brings it out. 12 seconds to shoot for the Saints. Gives to Dingus. She gets into the paint. 8-foot floating jumper. No good. Rebound to Stevens. Chesney Stevens, a good box out, and brings in that rebound. And London Pavlica controls for Dixie State. He gives to Stevens. Back to Pavlica as they play two-man game. Pavlica now gives to Gillen, back to Pavlika, now to Stevens on the high post, the free throw line extended area. Back to Pavlika, she's got an open three, she'll take it, and she'll miss it off the back iron, but a good open look for London Pavlika. She loves to take those when she's got an open look. She doesn't shoot too often, but she can hit those. That one, however, just comes off back iron. The long rebound out, however, keeps the ball on this end with Dixie State. Kinsley Stevenson back into the ballgame, replacing Brianna Gillen. Stevenson, 3 points on one made three-pointer in that first half. Long outlet pass to Pavlika. She's calling out the play for Dixie State. Backdoor pass to Maddie Loftus. She goes up, can't get the layup to go, but a good backdoor pass by London Pavlika and a good play design from Loftus. Read that her defender was denying the ball. She goes backdoor, can't get the layup to go, but is going to be bumped and fouled. She'll go to the free throw line for two shots. Jayla Russ charged with the personal foul, her first fourth team foul. Maddie Loftus perfect from the free throw line on the season. 13 of 13 now. She's got 12 points on the afternoon, leading all scorers for Dixie State. Spin of the ball and gets the friendly bounce. 13 points now for Loftus as she connects on both free throws. 48-44 lead Dixie State. 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Sutterlick gets to her left hand, can't get it to go. Maddie Loftus with the rebound. She brings it across the timeline for Dixie State. She'll fake a three in transition. She loves to take those three-pointers in transition. That one, she decides not to take it as Pavlika now controls down to the low block to Kesley Stevenson. Kicks to Pavlika, back to Stevenson at the left right junction. He's looked, tries to find a cutter, can't do it. Was trying to find Isaacson underneath and stolen away by Dingus. Into the front court now is Schultz. She gives to Vivola. She'll try another three-pointer. No good. This one short. Rebound to Stevens. She went up high to get that one and bring that one down for Dixie State. Pavlika controls right hand to left hand dribble now. Gives to Stevens, top of the key. She dribble handoff, fake with Maddie Loftus. Now she'll go back door to Loftus. She's got it underneath. Kicks it out to Stevenson. And the top of the key around the perimeter now to Isaacson at the top of the key. Pavlika has it. Thought about a three. Now she'll drive. She gets into the paint. She goes up and fouled. Cannot get the layup to go, but a good dribble penetration from London Pavlika. They're going to give the foul. Another one to Jalen Russ as Pavlika gets into the paint, fake the pass to the corner, and Jayla Russ was in the restricted area and draws her second personal foul. London Pavlika now goes to the free throw line to shoot two. 102 remaining as Pavlika drills the first one. 3 points now for the sophomore guard from Liberty High School in Las Vegas, Nevada. Trailblazers open up a 5-point lead. 49-44, the second free throw is missed, but rebounded by Isaacson, who goes down low to Stevens. And that one was kicked and knocked away by the Saints. Good hustle play by Isaacson to get that offensive rebound and keep it alive. And now the Trailblazers will regain possession. Stevenson gives to Pavlika. Under a minute now to play in the third quarter. 45-44 lead for Dixie State. Screen and roll with Isaacson and Pavlika. Pavlika yo-yoing, gives to Loftus, fakes right, goes left, gets into the paint, kicks out to Stevenson. 15-foot jumper, no good. Chesney Stevens can't get the short corner jumper to go, and Schultz controls into the front court now for the Saints. Vivola. Now to Schultz, right corner. And a whistle and a foul underneath. They're going to get, looks like, Kesley Stevenson. Her first personal foul, second team foul of the quarter, 30 seconds to go, but it is in the bonus. Excuse me, should not be shooting. That's going to be only the first foul under 2 minutes. In order to get to the bonus under 2 minutes, you have to have two team fouls under 2 minutes. That was just the first one under 2 minutes. And so no free throws for Dingus. And the Saints will retain possession. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Shot clock, game clock being separated by eight seconds as Schultz gets it top of the key. Now to the corner to Vivola. She drives baseline. She tries to lay it up. She does, and a foul. And then some extracurriculars after. Not sure what happened. Kesley Stevenson was involved. Looked like she might have shoved someone. Let's see as Vivola goes down low. Yeah, I'm not sure what exactly that was. Isaacson's going to be called for the foul. Vivola lays it up and in. She gets the foul and the basket. Going to call a foul on Maddie Loftus. Love to see if we can get another replay on that to see who they actually got the foul on. They announced Maddie Loftus, but I'm not sure. Certainly didn't look like to me it was Loftus. She was nowhere in the area. It's going to be on Isaacson. There's the foul there. Isaacson, and then just, I don't know if it was a shove by Dingus. Dingus was kind of shoving. Kelly Stevenson was kind of shoving. I think Dingus might have shoved Stevenson. Stevenson might have shoved Vivola. Couple of different shoves there from both teams. Not sure who instigated that one, but certainly blame to go around for Dixie State. And they're going to do double technical fouls. Looks like they're going to give
technical fouls on the assist to number 11, Dixie State.
Double technical fouls. Just trying to get the word here from the referee. Double technical foul is going to be assessed to Kesley Stevenson and Claire Dingus. As they kind of were pushing underneath the basket, referee now explaining things to both coaches, J.D. Gustin and the head coach for the Saints, Christy Martin. And you see there, kind of just both shoving each other. I'm not sure who instigated it, but kind of both shoving each other. And they're going to be called for the double technical foul. So those will offset. No free throws necessary. The 2 points is good from Mallory Vivola. And she'll go to the free throw line for the and one. The foul was still given to Maddie Loftus, even though she was nowhere in the play. I guess they're going to give it to Loftus. She was nowhere in the camera angle on both replays that we had, but they give the foul to Maddie Loftus, her first. Vivola's free throw is up and good. Shot clock turned off. Dixie State 49-47 leads. 17 seconds remaining. They'll have time to shoot for one shot. The Saints now come into a full court pressure to try to force the Trailblazers' hand. London Pavlika has it. She tries to get it across midcourt. She does to Kessie Stevenson. Six to shoot now. London Pavlika across to Maddie Loftus. She'll try a deep three, and she got it. Maddie Loftus near the end of the third quarter drills a deep three, and Maddie Loftus comes alive once again for Dixie State. She's up to 16 points, and she buries a three-pointer to give the Trailblazers a 52-47 lead at halftime. Off the assist, that was an NBA-range three-pointer. London Pavlika gives to Maddie Loftus, and she's come alive for Dixie State in this third quarter. And we will have one more quarter of action, 10 minutes up on the fourth quarter clock. Dixie State leads this one 52-47. We'll take a 60-second timeout and be back for the final quarter here on Trailblazer Basketball Network.
1 in 3 adults has prediabetes. That means it could be you. Your dog walker.
On your left.
Your cat jogger. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org.
I know kids worry about a lot of things. Getting enough food to eat shouldn't be one of them. Through a nationwide network of food banks, Feeding America serves virtually every community in the United States. See how you can help your community. Visit feedingamerica.org.
There is a place where young and old make connections. Where kids feel like grown-ups. And grown-ups feel like kids. There is a place where beauty arises in contrast. Where wonder is universal. And laughter, second nature. There is a place where friends find a future. Families find each other. And feelings find their home. There is a place.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. Fourth quarter action about to begin. 10 minutes remaining in this one. An interesting finish to the third quarter after the double technicals were assessed to Kesley Stevenson and Claire Dingus. Love to see if we can. Let's go back real quick and replay that one more time. I want to just see where Maddie Loftus was on that play. If we have that play at the end of the fourth quarter, end of the third quarter, and I wanted to see where Maddie Loftus is. And she was whistled for the foul. I mean, she was nowhere near the action. She was the one that was called for the personal foul. She didn't even touch anyone on that play. Should have been Emily Isaacson, but that is neither here nor there. Fourth quarter action underway in the hands of Sutterlicht. She gives to Detonatis on the right wing. Back to Sutterlicht in the corner. She holds, now puts the ball on the floor. Back to Detonatis as they play two-man game back and forth. Detonatis gives to Schultz, left wing, and out of Vivola. Right to left dribble, she drives baseline, cut off by Stevens. Back to the top of the key to Schultz, six to shoot for the Saints. She gets to the low block, it's cut off. Dingus now on the low block, and she's going to be called for 3 seconds in the key. Had just a few seconds remaining on the shot clock. Good defense on the opening possession for Dixie State. As you see there, 1, 2, 3 seconds in the key for Claire Dingus. And they'll turn it back over to Dixie State. Ashley Greenwood now controls for the Trailblazers. Right to left dribble, backdoor pass. Can't get it to Maddie Loftus. Now they do on the low block from Allie Franks. Cross-court pass to Gillen, who lost it, almost had it stolen away. And she goes to the rack, and she lays it up and in, and a foul. Brianna Gillen goes left to right and gets into the paint, goes from the left side of the floor to the right side underneath the basket. She gets it to go and will draw the foul on Janelle Sutterlicht, her first personal foul. And she'll go to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Should note Dixie State outscored the Saints 23-17 in that third quarter. They keep doing it every single game, as we've seen. They love to come out in that third quarter and make halftime adjustments, and they took control of the game in that third quarter, outscoring 23-17. Brianna Gillen now a 50% free throw shooter on the season. She buries that one. She's got 5 points and completes a three-point play for Dixie State as they open up an eight-point lead. 9 minutes remaining and change in this fourth quarter. 47-55, Dixie State leads. Detonatis with the ball. Veers right, now tries to get into the lane, cut off by Chesney Stevens. Cross-court pass into the corner. Schultz three-pointer, no good. Off right, and Janelle Sutterlich gets the rebound and tries to go right back to the rack, and she is fouled hard by Chesney Stevens. And Stevens will make her earn it from the free throw line, as that was a good foul, stopping a would-be wide-open layup by Sutterlich, and she'll go to the free throw line to shoot a pair of free throws. Sutterlich puts in the first, and she is really carried the offensive scoring load for the Saints for the majority of this game. And she puts in the second free throw. She's got a baker's dozen now. 13 points for Janelle Sutterlich, just 2 points per game average coming into today's game, and she leads all scorers, tied with Mallory Vivola on the Saints with 13 points. Loftus down to Franks on the low block. Cross-court pass to Stevens into the corner to Gillen. She drives baseline. Had Allie Franks behind her. She turns around and shoots it for three. No good. Rebound chased down by McKenna Schultz. She's quickly in the front court. Down court pass to Dingus. She was wide open. A good find from Mikkel Schultz to Claire Dingus, who is streaking down the court and had a wide open layup. 55-51 now. Dixie State leads. Ashley Greenwood dribble handoff with Allie Franks. Holding. Picks up her dribble. And now gives to Gillen, top of the key, puts it on the floor. Fakes left, goes right. Now gives to Ashley Greenwood. She dribbles into the paint, gets into the restricted area. Left-hand layup is good. Ashley Greenwood gets into the painted area and gets into the restricted zone and lays that one up and in with the left hand. She has 13 now. Dixie State maintaining a six-point lead, 57-51. Under 8 minutes to go now in the fourth quarter. Tierney Detonatis controls and tries to get it into Thames, and she can't do it. Throws it away, and Maddie Loftus controls for Dixie State. She grabs the steal and brings it into the front court and hands to Ashley Greenwood. Being guarded closely by Detonatis, putting a lot of pressure on the ball right now, and Ashley Greenwood burns by her. Gives to Allie Franks, thought about a three, and now goes backdoor, tries to find Gillen, who can't track it down. Pass just led Gillen a little bit too far, and she was not able to track it down. Tried to save it at the last second, but stepped on the end line, and the Trailblazers will turn it over. Dixie State leading this one 57-51, and now give the Saints an opportunity. Left hand, left to right dribble from Thames, can't get it to go. The rebound is kicked out to Gillen, who goes all the way coast to coast, gives to Allie Franks, who's cut off by Dingus. And now entry pass is tipped and stolen away. Now gets back in the hands of Allie Franks, and she goes all the way to the basket. A broken play by Allie Franks, but she picks it up and scores her 11th point. She's now in double figures with 11. On the other end now, Sutterlich. She controls left-hand dribble, guarded by Ashley Greenwood. Now she'll stop. She'll shoot a three, a pull-up three-pointer, and she'll hit it. Janelle Sutterlich has been unbelievable today. 16 points for the freshman guard from Toppenish, Washington. Average, I've said it 100 times today, and I'll say it again, averaged 2 points coming into today's game. She now leads all scorers with 16 points. We will take a timeout on the floor. 59-54 lead for Dixie State, 6:38 to go. We'll be back in 60 seconds on the Trailblazers Basketball Network.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
Hey, Kevin, you thinking about retirement?
I'd love to, but I'm pretty busy with all this.
Yeah. Hey, let's meet our retirement coach, Avo.
Thanks for taking action.
Not anxiety?
No, Kevin, you're gonna be fine.
You sing?
Barely. V is for variety.
And you dance?
Sort of. Come on. O's for optimize your savings.
Let Avo lead the way.
Visit aceyourretirement.org today.
Nice.
Thanks.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. Trailblazers holding on to a 5-point lead, 59-54, 6:38 remaining in this fourth quarter. It's been a good game, an up and down and a high pace, heavy offense, a high-paced offensive game, and the Trailblazers maintaining a 5-point lead over the Saints from St. Martin's University. Ashley Greenwood controls for the Trailblazers. Cross-court pass to Gillen. She drives baseline. Floating layup is no good. And an over-the-back is going to be called on Chesney Stevens. Her fourth personal foul. Second team foul of the quarter for Dixie State. And she'll have to be subbed out with four personal fouls. Emily Isaacson now into the ballgame for the Trailblazers. Janelle Sutterlich, she controls for the Saints. She's done everything for them offensively today. Sutterlich now gives to Schultz, who dribbles back around the perimeter and a dribble handoff with Mallory Vivola. Vivola dribbles to her left, gets into the paint, tries to spin back to her left, and floating hook shot is good by Mallory Vivola. And they cut back in the lead 59-56. Ashley Greenwood now sets up the offense for Dixie State. High post to Allie Frank. She does waste any time. She goes all the way to the basket. Floating jumper is no good, but she's going to be called for a foul. Excuse me, she's going to be called. Dingus is going to be called for the foul on Allie Franks, I should say, and she's going to go to the free throw line and get a pair of free throws. Just about had that floating jumper to go. You see here, she doesn't waste any time, puts the ball on the deck immediately, gets bumped right there. And a pretty good defense by Dingus, but she does get her down low on the body. And Allie Franks, a 78% free throw shooter coming into today's game, will go to the line for a pair of free throws. A deep knee bend and can't get the first one to go. Allie Franks, 11 points, trying to give the Trailblazers a 4-point lead as they nearing the 60-point mark. Long look at the basket, flick of the wrist, and up and good for Allie Franks. The senior from Enterprise High School. Sutterlich now running on double pick action. Dribble handoff with Vivola. Top of the key to Thames. She's been quiet in the second half. Right to left dribble now stops, pivots, hangs, and can't hit. Allie Franks gets the rebound quickly to London Pavlika, who slows the tempo for Dixie State and pulls it out, setting up the offense. Right to left dribble now comes back to her right. It's the angle right. Allie Franks tries to go back door, can't find Maddie Loftus, gives to Isaacson, now back to Franks, top of the key. Maddie Loftus now holds on the right junction. Dribble handoff with Pavlika. She gets to the 15-foot free throw area, and she knocks it down. A nice handoff by Maddie Loftus to London Pavlika, who got to the free throw line area and took that 15-foot jumper and knocked it home. London Pavlika now with 5 points on the afternoon. Sutterlich gives to Schultz, angle left. Holding now puts the ball on the floor. Gives to Thames, top of the key. She loves to drive to her left, and she does just that. She gets to the low block, now spins back to her right, and the hook shot is no good, but she gets her own rebound. Goes back now to her left, and now she'll pull it out. That's what Thames loves to do. She loves to go to her left and tries to get it into the restricted area. The Trailblazers have done a good job in containing her in the second half. She is scoreless in the second half. Schultz now down and tries to throw it to Nelson. It's stolen away by Allie Frank. She's got numbers on the other end. Now she pulls it back, and the Trailblazers will set up shop in the half court. 62-56 lead, 4:15 to go in the fourth quarter. London Pavlika, she'll try that same 16-foot jumper, and she'll hit another one. London Pavlika with back-to-back field goals from the same general area of the floor around that free throw line area, and she's knocked down her 7th point of the afternoon. Sutterlich yo-yos with the left hand, guarded by Maddie Loftus as she steps out. Now veers to her left to the angle right, now cuts back into the middle. Gets into the paint, picks up a dribble. Needs to find someone, tries to find a cutter. She does, gives it to Vivola. Dribbled it off her foot. Megan Nilsson tracks it down into the corner out of Vivola. She'll try a three and she'll hit it. A broken play that nearly saw the Saints turn the ball over, but Vivola gives to Megan Nilsson on a give and go, and Vivola gets it back in the corner. And how about this? Mallory Vivola off the bench has scored 18 points for the Saints. She only averages 4 points per game coming into today's game. And the Trailblazers will have to see if they can find an answer for her and Sutterlicht as we finish the last 3 minutes and 40 seconds inside Burns Arena. Dixie State leads this one by four. We'll take a 60-second timeout and be back on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
For over a century, Dixie State University has been shaping the Trailblazers of tomorrow by providing a culture of active learning, active life. With a paradigm of real-world experience mixed with cutting-edge technologies and rich traditions, we provide one of the most affordable educations in the West, set against the most stunning backdrop on the planet.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, good. You played before, right?
Oh, absolutely. It's okay. All state, high school.
Good, let's run some routes. Give me a post route.
All right, let's do it.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center. We'll see you there.
Welcome back inside the broadcast. Trailblazers trying to hold on to this one, a 64-59 lead with 3:40 remaining in the fourth quarter. Trailblazers trying to maintain their win streak, which stands at three in a row coming into today's game. Allie Franks gives to Isaacson, back to Franks, and now to Gillen on the left junction. Gives to Pavlika, that same area. Now they guard her on that 15-foot jumper. Don't let her take it. And now Gillen gets it. She drives all the way to the basket. Left-hand layup is good. Brianna Gillen goes to the basket and finishes at the rim. She's got 7 points. On the other end, Dingus, she'll try a long jumper, no good. Rebound controlled by Pavlika. Pavlika now into the front court. No one stops the ball. She'll kick it out to Gillen. Thought about a three, and now she'll pull it back out to Pavlika. And she'll go all the way, gets into the paint, hangs on a pivot, and she catches the rim and in. London Pavlika has come alive with 3 buckets and 6 points in this quarter, and she's got 9 for Dixie State. Into the hands of Schultz on the other end to Dingus at the high post. She fakes a jumper, now back to Schultz. Thought about a step back three. Now she puts her back to the basket, gives to Nelson. Top of the key, low block into Dingus. That's too deep for Dingus. And she lays that one up and in. She's got 11, working on Allie Frank. She just got her too low in that low post area. And once you get her that low, she loves to score from that area of the floor. Whistle. Out of bounds, last touch by the Saints. And Dixie State holds on to possession, 68-61 lead, 2:10 to play. They're reached in, might have been last touch by Loftus, but they say out of bounds, last touched by the Saints. And Dixie State will retain possession. Gillen triggers the inbounds to Loftus. She turns a turnaround three-pointer, no good. And Allie Franks try to keep it alive, but the Saints grab the rebound. Down low to Dingus. She can't get the layup to go from point blank as she cut down the baseline, and a nice pass by Sutterlicht. And then a whistle and a foul as Sutterlicht commits a turnover 65 feet away from the basket. Excuse me, then a kind of call Claire Dingus on that one. That's her fourth personal foul after the technical foul. Excuse me, there. Saying it's 5. I've only got 4 on my end. But they're saying it's 5. Maybe they're coming over to talk about it. Claire Dingus certainly doesn't think she has 5. She's trying to explain to the referee that she's only got 4. Referee speaking now with the stat crew to try to see how many fouls we actually have. And they said that they only had four. I only have four on my score sheet. Of course, my score sheet is unofficial, but that would be a huge loss for the Saints. Claire Dingus, if she were to foul out, leading all scorers coming into the game by average of 15 points per game. She has 11, and she's just started to heat up with a couple of points. They do say she has only four fouls. No. They say she has five fouls. Wow. I don't believe that. And head coach for the Saints is irate, and I don't blame her. I've only got four fouls on my end. The stat crew only thinks they have four fouls on their end. And the head coach, Christy Martin, is extremely upset, and I can't blame her. So Claire Dingus fouls out. That double technical foul comes back to hurt her, and I don't know if she has five fouls or not, but the pressure has been ramped up. J.D. Gustin forced to call a timeout as London Pavlika was being double-teamed in the front court, and he gets a word of the timeout, 68-61. It's just going to be a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here for this one and talk a little bit about what just transpired. It's been a crazy game to this point. We had the double technical fouls earlier in the game. Kesley Stevenson and Claire Dingus kind of just were, you know, shoving each other kind of back and forth, and they both were assessed technical fouls, and that has now come back to haunt the Saints as Claire Dingus fouls out with apparently five fouls. And, you know, Christy Martin, the head coach for the Saints in her third season, was absolutely irate that she was called for five fouls. She could not believe it. And the stat crew now having to work frantically to get that change corrected in the official stats, as the Trailblazers try to hold on to a 7-point lead, 140 remaining. London Pavlika trying to be double-teamed. She evades it, gets it to Stevens in the corner, and she is fouled. Going to be called on Megan Nelson, her third personal foul. Not a shooting foul for Dixie State. Four fouls now for St. Martin's. That was their foul to give. Next foul will put them over the limit and put the Trailblazers on the free throw line. Megan Nielsen comes out. Tierney Didonatis comes back in. London Pavlika triggers the inbounds pass for Dixie State. She gives to Allie Franks. Now back to Pavlika in the corner, being hounded closely by Bria Thames. She gets it to Gillen. Top of the key, guarded by Vivola. She tries to drive, gets into the low block area. She gives to Stevens, who pump fakes, tries to go up, can't lay it up and in. Thought she might have drawn contact, but a good up and under, can't get that one to go, however. And the Saints into the front court. Now three-pointer is up, no good, too strong by Sutterlicht. And two players going for the rebound. It's going to be called a dead ball foul, or a loose ball foul, on Allie Franks, her first of the game. And she was going for the layup, and she kind of just put her backside there into Bria Thames and knocked her down. And that will be her first foul of the game. As Ashley Greenwood comes back in, replacing Brianna Gillen. Not a shooting foul for the Trailblazers. They still have one foul to give. Three-pointer is up by Sutterlicht, and she buries it. Janelle Sutterlicht now with 19 points and cuts the lead in half, 68-64, under a minute to go. Maddie Loftus has it, and she is fouled immediately as the Saints were trying to steal that ball away. They're going to give the foul to McKenna Schultz, her second foul of the game, and it will send Maddie Loftus to the free throw line. And if you're Dixie State, that's exactly who you want taking these free throws. She is a perfect 14 of 14 on the season, including 2 of 2 today. And her first free throw, of course, broadcaster's jinx, and she misses the first one. First missed free throw for Maddie Loftus on the season. And she will get one more. Shallow knee bend, and she puts it through. And the Trailblazers still maintaining a 5-point lead, 69-64, 59 seconds remaining. And the Trailblazers hold on. Janelle Sutterlicht with 19 points she controls. She looks to shoot. Thought she might have picked up her pivot foot. She doesn't. Thames gets the offensive rebound, and she is fouled on the putback attempt, and she'll go to the free throw line for two. They get Allie Franks on her second foul. And Sutterlicht got into that high post, that free throw line extended area, and was hanging on a pivot and tried to get that one to go, but Bria Thames tracked down the offensive rebound and draws the foul, and she'll go to the free throw line for two. Critical free throws here for St. Martin's. And she hits the first. St. Martin's as a team shooting 62% from the free throw line this season. They've done better today from the free throw line as Thames misses the second one. 7 of 9 after that miss by the Saints in today's game after coming into the game at 62% as a team. And we have a timeout.
Timeout,
Dixie State. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, I believe. It's going to be a 60. They're extended to a 60. So we'll take the timeout. 60 seconds and back on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
We scored going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that.
Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone.
What?
I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what? Yep, that's mine.
I'm going to need that back.
Nope.
Kevin!
There is a place where the desert comes alive. Where rain breaks forth from solid stone and gardens spring from blistered rock. There is a place with enough color to make a rainbow jealous. Where boulders are bigger than buildings and cliffs are higher than clouds. There is a place that will straighten your step, tighten your grip, widen your eyes, and open your jaw. There is a place.
Welcome back inside Burns Arena. Trailblazers holding on to a four-point lead, 69-65 over St. Martin's with 48 seconds remaining. A critical miss on the other end by Bria Thames. Only a 58% free throw shooter coming into the game. And she misses on the second half of the two free throws that would have cut it to a three-point game. Now the Trailblazers inbound to Gillen. Cross-court pass from Greenwood. Gillen now tries to penetrate, is cut off to Allie Franks, and now into the corner by Pavliga, and she is bumped and fouled by Tierney Detonatis. And she will go to the free throw line and shoot two shots. London Pavliga, a 57% free throw shooter on the season today. She is 1 of 2 from the free throw stripe today. She'll get two free throws. First one is up and good. A high arcing shot from London Pavliga. She's now in double figures with 10. 2 of 3 from the free throw line today. 10 points, 4 rebounds, and an assist for London Pavliga. She knocks through the second one. She's up to 11 for Dixie State. 71-65 lead, 35 seconds to go. The Saints control. Sutterlicht, she'll try a step back 3-pointer, and she drills it. Janella Sutterlicht has been phenomenal for the Saints all game long, and she keeps them in it. It's now a one-possession game. Shot clock is still turned on. Dixie State does have to shoot it, but only separated by about 1.5 seconds. The Saints are going to have to foul. They had to foul as there was only about a second difference between shot clock and game clock. It's going to be on number 10, McKenna Schultz, her third, and it will send Maddie Loftus to the free throw line, who has been excellent from the free throw stripe this season. She's got 17 points today, and she misses on the first one, so that makes it interesting. As you see the foul there, Loftus, 3 of 5 from the free throw stripe today. She will get one more. This makes it a two-possession game, and she makes it. 18 points for Maddie Loftus off the Dixie State bench, and that makes it a little bit more difficult for the Saints. A 72-68 lead for Dixie State with 18 seconds remaining. One more final timeout, 60 seconds and back on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
honorary forest ranger Betty White here, lending a hand to my dear friend Smokey Bear. Because for 75 years, he's only said,
only you can prevent wildfires.
But there's a lot more to say. Like, if you park your car on tall, dry grass, the hot exhaust pipe can start a wildfire. So keep the animals safe, especially the cute shirtless one. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
I got you right where I want you. I make this one. It's over. I win.
No pressure. Bring it.
We may not always play good, but when we want to look good, we come to the Dixie State Campus Store.
Located on the second floor of the Gardner Center.
Back in Brad Burns Arena. Detonatus cross-court pass to Sutterlicht. She hits another three. Janelle Sutterlicht keeps the Saints alive. And she's got 25 points, and J.D. Gustin forced to call a timeout. Janelle Sutterlicht has put the Saints on her back today, and she has carried the offensive load for St. Martin's. A good play design, a cross-court pass, got Janelle Sutterlicht a wide-open three-pointer, and she has done everything for St. Martin's today. 25 points on 35 minutes, 9 of 17 from the field. She's 5 of 10 from three-point range, perfect from the free throw line. She's grabbed 6 rebounds and 2 assists for the Saints, and she is their leading scorer, in fact, leading all scorers in the ball game with 25 points. She's really kept them in this throughout the entire game, especially after Claire Dingus fouled out, who was starting to get hot, had a few buckets there earlier on in this fourth quarter, was trying to keep the Saints alive, and she had to go to the bench with 5 fouls, and still 5 fouls that I don't know where the fifth one came from. But Dixie State holds on to a 1-point lead, 11 and a half seconds. Both teams still have one foul, one timeout left. No fouls to give either way. The Trailblazers will have to inbound, and they will be immediately fouled. The Saints obviously are going to try to get a steal on the inbounds pass, but if the Trailblazers can get it in, they'll have to make a couple free throws at the stripe to make it a 3-point game. They will trigger the inbound. It's Brianna Gillen on the far sideline. She will trigger the inbounds pass, has Franks and Pavlikin near her. She gets it into Maddie Loftus, into the corner, and she is fouled. That one was close to a 5-second call as they get it into Maddie Loftus into the corner, and she is fouled immediately. She'll go to the free throw line for two. Thought that one was close. Almost was tipped out of bounds by McKenna Schultz, but fortunately for Dixie State, was able to get it into Maddie Loftus. She'll go to the free throw line for two. Two critical free throws for Dixie State. 9.7 seconds remaining. The Saints do still have a timeout. In all likelihood, they will call that and advance the ball to half court. Make or miss as Maddie Loftus puts in the first free throw. 19 points now for Loftus. She gets one more. This will make it a 3-point game. And the Saints would have to take a quick two or a three-pointer to tie. Loftus' second free throw is up, rolls around the rim, and falls. 20 points now for Maddie Loftus. And the Saints do call a timeout. We'll keep it right here. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it. They will advance the ball, and we'll have it on the far sidelines. And it's going to be a 30-second timeout. Dixie State, one final play. They have to get one final stop. And it's been a crazy game back and forth. The Trailblazers, largest lead of the game. I'm going to see if I can find that for you. Largest lead of the game for Dixie State was 9 points at 68-59. And since then, it's been a 12-6 run for the Saints over the final few minutes of this game. From down 9 points earlier in the quarter, now have a chance to tie it and send it into overtime. As we have under 10 seconds remaining, it's going to be interesting to see what they draw up. I had to turn down my microphone for 1 second. It's going to be interesting to see what they draw up And obviously they're going to want to get the ball in the hands of Janelle Sutterlich, who's got 25 points and 5 of 10 from deep on the afternoon. But obviously the Trailblazers are going to know that they're going to try to get it to Sutterlich for the final shot. Obviously they don't have any timeouts remaining. I'm going to assume they're not going to go for a quick two and try to foul. I assume they would have to try to go for three here, and we'll see what they do. It'll be Mallory Vivola to trigger the inbounds pass. Janelle Sutterlich being guarded closely by Ashley Greenwood. And here we go. They get it into Sutterlich. With 7 to shoot, she gives it to Detonatis. A flare pass to Sutterlich. She is cut off from 3. The ball is loose. It's going to go to Detonatis, and it's blocked. And Dixie State's going to hold on to win it. The play was broken to begin with. Janelle Sutterlich was cut off, did not have the 3, tried to kick it back out to Tierney Detonatis, and it was blocked, and the Trailblazers hold on and win this one 75-71. Ashley Greenwood gets her left hand on it, and Maddie Loftus secures the rebound, and the Trailblazers hold on to win a thriller. This one came down to the wire and the very last possession. 74-71 win for Dixie State. They improved to 5-1 on the season and maintain their win streak at 4 games now after defeating the Saints from St. Martin's University. A good game. Let's wrap it up for you. We're going to take a quick 2-minute timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you some second half highlights. We'll give you some second half stats, and we'll wrap things up and get you out of here in the final game of the Dixie State Classic as the Trailblazers win 74-71. 2 minutes and back for the postgame show on the Trailblazer Basketball Network.
You know, we may have started out small, but we were great. Families and fans rallied behind their team. The community cared, and everyone showed up to cheer. Now, we're bigger than ever. Dixie State is going to Division I.
Here we go in transition, and he throws it down with one hand.
Lobs.
Catch me.
But at the end of the day, it's the community and fans that make us great. Whether you give $5 or $1,000, every dollar, every seat in the stands, every one of you can help blaze our trail to Division I athletics. Because this is our team.
Hey guys, how are you today?
Good.
I'm here to talk about how with technology you can make amazing worlds.
Come with me.
My team and I bring the Halo world to life.
Is that you?
That is me. I wasn't a math genius and I knew nothing about coding. But you guys do. You guys have the power to change things.
I want your job.
I want you to have my job.
I take the road less traveled, run free, unwind, unravel. Someplace outside with lots to do. Green trees, red rocks, and don't forget that blue sky. The sunshine shining, fun shine, pouring on me. Think I might just stay a while. Say hooray all day because the sun is gonna shine.
Welcome back inside the broadcast. Dixie State wins this one 74-71 over St. Martin's. A thrilling finish all the way to the end. And the Trailblazers improve to 5-1 on the season and maintain their 4-game win streak as they defeat St. Martin's in a thrilling finish. The Trailblazers fortunate to get away with the win on this one. And I sort of said this earlier that, you know, the Trailblazers coming into the game, I'd have thought that they could, walk to a victory after seeing the St. Martin Saints lose by 25 points to Colorado Mesa in the first game of the Dixie State Classic, but not to be today. The Trailblazers had their hands full from start to finish with the Saints of St. Martin's University, but they do earn the victory. Let's get a few second-half highlights for you, a few second-half stats. Let's run those highlights for you right now as we see some second-half highlights. Kesley Stevenson buries the three-pointer. She had just 3 points. That was her only points of the game. But then the offensive rebound there by Allie Franks. She finishes with 12 points in the afternoon. She gets the offensive rebound and the putback. Maddie Loftus was huge, especially in the third quarter. She had, I believe, 8 or 9 points in that third quarter alone, and there she is, another one on the pass from Brianna Gillen, who penetrated and kicked it into the corner for Maddie Loftus, and there she is one more time. That was her third three of the third quarter, and she was tremendous, flat out making everything in that third quarter. Then Gillen, of course, gets into the lane, a nice drive there, and one. She goes to the free throw line, converts the three-point play. Ashley Greenwood on the left-hand layup gets that one to go, and then Lennon Pavlik on back-to-back possession. She hit two shots from that very same area, and that was the first one. This is the second one, and she had a little 4-0 run over her own. And then this one, that was the final play of the game, a block from Ashley Greenwood to seal the victory for Dixie State, and they hold on to win this one 74-71. And it was not without controversy, however, as we had a few different events in the game that kind of told the story of this one a little bit. Obviously, we had the double technical fouls earlier on in the game. Kesley Stevenson and Claire Dingus kind of got tangled up a little bit, had a little bit of a shoving match. Both were assessed technical fouls on that play, and that played a big role coming down into the second half. And Claire Dingus was ruled to be fouled out after she picked up a foul early on in the fourth quarter. And I'm not sure, again, I only had them on my score sheet that I have in front of me. I only had four fouls. I had the three personal fouls, and then I had the technical foul, which counts as a personal foul. Obviously, my records are far from the official stats of the game. But even the stat crew that runs the program next to me on the computer, they only had four fouls. It was the official scorekeeper that had five fouls on Claire Dingus. And so it's going to be interesting to see exactly how that turns out. But it did play a role into the Okay, just got the explanation from the stat crew. They said they just plugged in a wrong number at the beginning of the quarter, and instead plugged in 14, they plugged in 13 to begin one of the quarters, and that was where the difference was made. However, it played a role into the second half as Claire Dingus, the leading scorer coming into the game for the Saints, fouls out. But the story really lied for the Saints was Janelle Sutterlicht, who had 25 points on the afternoon. She was fantastic. She carried the scoring for much of the game, and especially in the second half. She had a couple of big threes down the stretch. She finishes with 25 points, also had 6 rebounds and 2 assists for the Saints. Claire Dingus finishes with 11 points, and Mallory Vivola also had 19 points as well for St. Martin's, and they come up just a little bit short as Dixie State holds on to win this one. Leading scorers for Dixie State is Maddie Loftus. She had 20 points. She was 4 of 7 from 3, 5 of 9 from the field, and 6 of 8 from the free throw line. She had a couple big free throws down the stretch, and she helped ice the victory for Dixie State. Ashley Greenwood contributed 13 points, 5 rebounds for Dixie State. Allie Franks had 12 points, 8 rebounds, also chipped in 4 assists. London Palagas filled up the stat sheet once again, 11 points and 4 rebounds. Brianna Gillen finishes with 7 points. Chesney Stevenson finishes with 4 points. Kesley Stevenson finishes with 3. And Emily Isaacson and Brianna Moyai both had 2 points for Dixie State. Trailblazers shot very well in that second half. Did not take a 3-pointer, interestingly enough, in the fourth quarter. They were 7 of 11 in the fourth quarter from the field and 8 of 11 from the free throw line to help seal the victory. So they shoot 63% in the fourth quarter and increase their second half scoring and shoot 40% from the field in the game and 34% from the free throw line. 34% from the three-point line and 70% from the free throw line. 35% from the three-point line, 70% from the free throw line throughout the game, and they hold on to win the 74-71 victory over St. Martin's. Trailblazers improved to 5-1, as I mentioned, and they finish up the Dixie State Classic, winning both games against Northwest Nazarene University yesterday and against St. Martin's today. And they are now finished with non-conference play. They do have one more non-conference game a couple weeks from now. They'll play on December 2nd at Utah State. That's just an exhibition matchup. That's a non-conference game. That's their last official non-conference exhibition game of the season. But officially now we are into conference play as the Trailblazers will take on Westminster College on November 30th after Thanksgiving right here inside Burns Arena at 5:30 p.m. It's going to be a fun atmosphere and an in-state rival in Westminster going to be coming in to Dixie State. Going to be a fun game and a fun atmosphere, so we hope you come out into Burns Arena and enjoy that one. A couple of Dixie State former players now playing for Westminster, and it's going to be fun to see how they fare in their return to Burns Arena. For the CEC TV crew and everyone associated with the broadcast, that will do it for us from here. Trailblazers win this one 74-71. For Drayson Ball and the entire CEC TV crew, we hope to see you in a couple weeks against Westminster. Have a great afternoon, people.